Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be talking about Oracle GL period closure process. So GL is the last module to be closed. So first we need to ensure that all the subledger modules are closed, whether it's financials or non-financials, and then only we need to proceed with the GL period closure. So in general, in a client live environment, like all the subledger modules are closed on the last working day of the month, whereas GL will be closed in the first week of the next month. So if you take August as an example, so August will be closed roughly around on 31st of August, which is the last working day of the month, but whereas GL will be closed in the first week of the month, that will be around in the first week of September, and this will be the last module to be closed. So as far as the checklist are concerned, you should ensure that all the subledgers are closed. So even though subledgers are not closed, if you try to proceed with GL period closure, system will not stop you from closing the period. System will allow the period to be closed, but it's a business process where you need to ensure that all the subledger periods are closed. You should ensure that the data is clear in the GL interface, and if there is any records in GL interface, run the journal import program to import those journals into Oracle GL. Ensure that all the GL inbound interfaces are processed. If you have got any custom inbound interface to pull the data into Oracle GL from any legacy system, ensure that those programs are processed and the data is clear in the GL interface. Ensure that all the required GL adjustment entries are passed. Ensure that GL revaluation, if applicable, is run, and for that you need to run revaluation process, that's the name of the program. And you should ensure that all the required journal entries are approved and posted, and you can use the program, automatic posting program. And again, remember that even if there are any unposted or unapproved journal entries, system will not stop you from closing the period. System will allow the period to be closed. So this is just a business process to ensure that the required journal entries are approved and posted. And once all these items are taken care, you can proceed towards closing of the period. And if you have got the second ledger, ensure that the primary ledger is closed, and then you can again proceed towards closing of the second ledger. Again, there is no system control. You can go to the second ledger and close directly the second ledger. System will not stop you from doing that. But as a process, ensure that your primary ledger is closed, and then you proceed with closing of the secondary ledger. So as far as the closing is concerned, in release 11, you need to go to the close screen and click on a select the particular period and click on the drop down to change the status of the period from open to close. But whereas in R12, you can do the similar activity of selecting the period, clicking on the drop down, select the status from open to closed, or you can even run a program by name period close program. You can run the period close program to close the period. Now I'll show you that. So I am under General Ledger Supervisor Reliance INR. So as the name itself says, that this is a responsibility which is linked to Reliance INR ledger. Now I'm trying to proceed to close August period under Reliance INR ledger. So navigate to Setup, Open or Close, click on Find. So here you can see August period is open. Now I want to close the August period. So I can click on the drop down and change the status from open to closed. So I have two options, closed or permanently closed. If you select the permanently closed, then system will not allow the close period to be reopened. So if you change the status to closed, system will allow the period to be reopened. So now I'll change the status from open to, now the current status is open. Now I'll change the status to close. This is a primary ledger, and save this. See a message, transaction complete, one record appeared and saved. And as soon as you try to close the form, then a concurrent request get triggered, submitted one concurrent request. Now view request, click on find and check if the concurrent request is completed normal. Period close period. So as soon as you close the period, the program by name period close period gets triggered, and this particular program should be completed normal. If it is completing in warning, then you need to check the reason. So in this case, it will be completing in warning because I know there are some entries which are not posted in the current period, which is August 18. So if there are any unposted journals, system will allow the period to be closed, but period close period will program will be completing in warning, and the log file will show a message saying that there are unposted journal entries. See here, you can see it is completed in warning, there is no output, and click on log view log. Here you can see checking for unposted and unposted journals existing period August 18. So if there are any journals in unposted status, or even if there are any unprocessed rows in GL interface table, even then system will complete this particular program in warning status, but period will be still closed. So here it's just a warning. A query for this period, and you should be able to see the status as closed. And one other thing is, you can see that this particular program in turn triggered subledger period close exception report as well as the create reporting sequence. So first one is subledger period close exception report. So the subledger period close exception report gets triggered, and if you click on view output, if there are any exceptions in the subledger's transaction, then it will show that. So in this case, you should be able to see one exception. So I purposefully created one journal, one invoice in AP module, validated the invoice, but did not run the create accounting. So this is again another example wherein system will allow the GL period to be closed even though the subledger transactions are not processed and subledger period is not closed, but it will still allow the GL period to be closed, but and the record of the particular transaction will be appearing in the subledger period close exception report. So in this case, invoice number test 10010 is in unprocessed status. It is in August period. So from a system perspective, it will allow the GL period to be closed even though the subledger transactions are not processed. So it's up to the business users to ensure that they follow the checklist. Okay. So okay, as soon as you close the August period, you can very well open the September period. In this case, period is already open, but if you want to open the period, you need to click on open next period. And if you want to open any of the previous period, you can click on open target period and select the concerned target period. Okay, so that's how you close or open your general ledger, primary ledger period. Now, as the primary ledger period is closed, I will try to close the second ledger period. Setup, open and close, Reliance subledger level secondary, that's the name of my second ledger. Click on find, and I want to change the status from open to closed. See, a concurrent request get triggered. Check the output or the log file. If it completes in warning, and if it doesn't complete in warning, if it completes normal, so that means there are no unposted journal entries and there are no records stuck in GL interface table. So this program completes in warning only for the unposted journals or the journals which are stuck in the GL interface. And as far as the subledger unprocessed transactions are concerned, that should be appearing in your subledger period close exception report. So in this case, as for the second ledger is concerned, it is completed normal. So that means there are no unposted journal entries or there are no entries which are got stuck in the interface table. So if I look at the output, query for unposted, checking for unposted journals, and there are no unposted journals. There are no records in the GL interface table. So that's the reason why your subledger period close exception report got completed. The period close period report got completed normal. And apart from the subledger period close exception report, this period close period program also triggers create reporting sequence. If you are using the reporting sequence functionality, then this particular program is going to generate the reporting sequence number for all the journals under that particular period. If you are not using the reporting sequence concept, but still the create reporting sequence number program gets triggered, but it doesn't create any reporting sequence. So reporting sequence is nothing but a document number, reporting sequence document number generated for each general under the particular period. So if you reopen the period, the a program by name reset create reporting sequence or the create reporting sequence program gets triggered in reset mode. That means it is going to remove the reporting sequence, and then once you close the period, it is going to again trigger the create reporting sequence program, which is going to again generate the reporting sequence number for the journals under that particular period. Okay, so this is how you open or close the period through the form. But if you want to open or close the period through a concurrent program, you can click on submit new request. You can query for if it's closing, then you can say periods closed period, select the ledger and the period name. And if you want to open a period again through a program, you can just say open period, select the ledger name and the period to be opened. And in R2L, we also have a concept of opening or closing of the period for multiple ledgers through a single program. So those ledgers need to be under a ledger set. Now I have one responsibility by name General Ledger Supervisor Reliance Overseas. As the name itself says, for this particular responsibility, I have assigned the ledger set by name Reliance Overseas. So I'll show you the ledger set. So I have grouped Reliance Canadian ledger and Reliance UST ledger under this particular ledger set. So that means now using this particular responsibility, I should be able to open or close the period for two ledgers at a time. Now view a request, submit new request. I'll just say open period. And in the ledger or ledger set, you can select the ledger set. My ledger set is Reliance Overseas, and select the period to be open. So yes, yeah, maybe if I say example, say August 18, and click on OK. So once I click on OK, it is going to open the August period for both the Reliance Canadian ledger as well as the Reliance UST ledger. Similarly, if you want to close the period for all the ledgers under ledger set, select the ledger set name and select the period to be closed. So this is basically used by most of the clients who has got multiple ledgers. They generally group all those ledgers under ledger set and just run this particular program, which should take care of opening of the period or closing of the period for all the ledgers under the particular ledger set. So this will save a lot of time in for the users wherein like they were earlier navigating to multiple responsibilities to open the period in 11A. But as far as release 12 is concerned, they can very well use this particular program. And as far as the GL is concerned, once the period closure is completed, generally users will run a couple of FSG reports, which will generate a required financial statements for reporting purpose, or maybe a trial balance, or maybe any other reports which they deem fit necessary for their reporting purpose. And also, like if you are using a if you have a consolidation ledger, then run the translation process in all the concerned subsidiary ledgers, and then run the consolidation process, which will consolidate the data from the subsidiary ledgers into consolidation ledger, and then within the consolidation ledger post those journals and then close the consolidation ledger. So if you have the consolidation ledger, ensure that the consolidation ledger is the last ledger to be closed. So first close all your primary ledgers, and then once you run your consolidation process, push the data to your consolidation ledger, post them, then close your consolidation ledger. So this is how your period closure works in GL module. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. For interesting videos on Oracle Financial, please do subscribe to my channel. Do not forget to click on the bell button to get notifications on the latest videos. Thank you.